the real numbers. Exercise number 1.1 and 1.2 we have done. Now we are starting exercise number 1.3. But before starting exercise number 1.3, because exercise number 1.3 is based on irrational numbers. If you are knowing the irrational number, then only you can do exercise number 1.3. If you are unable to know the irrational numbers, so you are unable to do this exercise. Okay. So before exercise number 1.3, we have to know what do we call irrational numbers. Okay. So let us read about the irrational numbers. So today we are going to read irrational numbers in the series of real numbers. Okay. What are real numbers? Real numbers are irrational numbers plus rational numbers. Means irrational number and rational number you mix together, both are known as real numbers. Okay. Now what are rational numbers? Rational numbers are those numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q, like this. For example, like 2. 2 is a rational number. I can write it in the form of P by Q. How? 2 I can write 2 by 1 simply, or 4 by 2. I can write it in the form of P by Q. So 2, this is a rational number. Like 1 by 2, this is also a rational number, P by Q form. Okay. Now if you divide this, what, how much it will come? 0.5. So what is the decimal expansion here? Terminating. Because nothing coming now. So terminating decimal expansion. So what can I write? Rational numbers are those numbers which have terminating decimals. So terminating decimal. This is a terminating decimal. Because after 5 nothing coming. So this is a terminating decimal. So terminating decimals are also known as rational numbers. Clear? Now one more. Third one. Let's say suppose I divide 1 by 3. So if you are dividing 1 by 3, what will come? 0.3333. It keeps coming. It will never stop. 3333333. Till infinity it will come. Okay. So what is this? It is non-terminating. Terminating? No, it is non-terminating. So non-terminating decimal, but it is repeating. 3, 3, 3 all the time repeating. Okay. So means I can write the decimals non-terminating. Non-terminating and repeating. Non-terminating and repeating decimals. So non-terminating and repeating decimals are also called rational number. Terminating decimals are also called rational numbers. And the numbers which are in the form of P by Q are known as rational numbers. So rational number, three types of definition. In three ways you can define the rational numbers. What are the rational numbers? Rational numbers are those numbers which have terminating decimal expansion. Rational numbers are those numbers which have non-terminating but repeating decimal expansion. Okay. And rational numbers are those numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q. Now what are the irrational numbers? Rest are irrational. Rest are irrational means which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Means you cannot write rational number in the form of P by Q. Okay. Second. So which type of decimal expansion then? For example. For example. Like 0.10 1 0 0 1 0 0 0 1 0 0 0 0 1. It keeps coming. So is it repeating? Not repeating. Like here 10 coming. Then after 10, what is coming? 100 coming. Not 10 coming. Then after 100, 1000 coming. Repeating? Not repeating. Are you getting it? So it means it is non-terminating. Non-terminating it means and not there. Na? So non-terminating but not repeating also. Okay? So means non-terminating and non-repeating decimal. So what are irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are non-terminating and non-repeating decimals. Non-terminating and non-repeating decimals are known as irrational numbers. Because you cannot write this in the form of divide. You cannot. Are you getting this now? And also the numbers which are in the form of the square root. The number which are in the form of square root. But which are not perfect square. You have to understand this. The number which are in the form of square root are known as irrational. Because square root of 2, it is not having any fixed value. Its value is like this. 1.41 etc. etc. Not repeating. Not repeating, not terminating. So it is a irrational number. Like under root 3, this is also irrational. Value 1.732 etc. Non terminating, non repeating. So this is also irrational number. Under root 4, no. 4 is a perfect square. So 4 is a rational number. Under root 4 is a rational number because under root 4 can be written as 2. 4 is the perfect square of 2. So 2 is a rational number. So it will not be a rational number. So what are irrational numbers? Irrational numbers are those numbers which are in the form of square root, but they are not perfect square. Okay? Under root 5 is also irrational number. Under root 7, irrational. Under root 6 also irrational. Why? Because 6 is not a perfect square. 6 is not perfect square. So 6 is also irrational. You can write under root 7, not perfect square. Under root 8, not perfect. Under root 9, 9 is a perfect square. 9 is the square of 3. So 9 is a perfect square. So under root 9 will be rational number. Are you getting this? So can you differentiate what are rational and what are irrational? Yes. Irrational are non-terminating, non-repeating. Rational are non-terminating but repeating. Are you getting? Irrational numbers are cannot be written in the form of value, but they can be written. Irrational numbers are in the form of square root, but not perfect square. But they are in the form of square root also, but they all are perfect squares. Under root 4, rational. Under root 16, rational. Under root 9, rational number. Are you differentiating it now? So this is how we will explain what are the irrational number and what are the rational numbers. Is it clear? Clear na? Clear? Now, in this chapter, in this exercise number 1.3, we are not going to study irrational numbers because irrational numbers we are already knowing. Here we are going to prove the irrationality of a number. Here you will have to prove how under root 2 is an irrational number. Prove it. You have to prove. You have to prove that under root 2 is an irrational number. But how? You have to prove here. So in this exercise, we will have to prove the irrationality of numbers. How a number is an irrational number? You have to prove that. We are saying that under root 2 is a rational number. Why? Because it cannot be written in the form of p by q. But how? Prove it. We need proof. Okay? So, irrationality of the numbers we will do in this one exercise. Exercise number 1.3. Okay? But before this, let me tell you a theorem. This theorem will help you. Theorem says that let p be a prime number. Let P be a prime number. Now what say? If A is a positive integer. Positive. What I am saying? Let P be a prime number. Prime number means which are divisible by itself only. Like 5, 5 is divisible by 5 only. 3, 3 divisible by 3 only. 7, 7 divided by 7 only. Are you getting this now? So let P be a prime number and A is a positive integer. Positive integer means 1, 2, 3, 4 natural numbers. Okay? And A is a positive integer. Now, what question is what? The theorem is what? If P divides A square, this prime number p is dividing a square. So it means what? If p divides a square, then p divides a also. Means if p is dividing a square, like if 3 is dividing 9 square, if 3 is dividing 9 square, so it means 3 will divide 9 also. Are you getting this now? If 3 is dividing 9 square, it means 3 will divide 9 also. Same way, if p is dividing a square, so p will divide a also. This way you have to prove it. Are you getting this? So this is the theorem. Let's see how will we prove it. Now, I have told a is a positive integer. So, if any positive integer, you can write the prime factors of any positive. Let's say 6. 6 is a positive integer. I can factorize it. I can write the prime factors of 6. 2 multiply 3. So, if a is a positive integer, I can write the factors of a. So, factors will be prime numbers. Let's say it has 3 prime factors. P1, P2, P3. These are the prime factors of A. Okay. Are you getting? Now, square. Square of A will be square of P1 multiply square of P2 multiply square of P3. Clear? Both sides square. Clear. Now, question is what? If P divides A square, now there is a number P, this is dividing A square. Now, this A square is divisible by P. It means, this P will divide these three also. Because these are the factors, na? P is dividing A square means what? P is dividing these factors also. Okay. Now, if P is dividing these factors, it means this P is cutting either P1, P is cutting P2 or P is cutting P3. Means any of these, suppose if 2 is dividing, I said, if 3 is dividing 9 square. And what are the factors of 9 square? 9 square is 81. If P is dividing 81, what are the factors of 81? 3 is 9, 9 is 27, 27, 3 is 81. By 3. It means the 3 is cutting any of the factors, means it can be cutting this one also. So same here also. This P is dividing A square, means P is dividing the factors also. It means the P is cutting any one of these. So it might be that P is cutting P1. So P is cutting P1. It means P is dividing P1. P is dividing P2 or P is dividing P3. If P is dividing P1, P is dividing P2, P is dividing P3, it implies P divides, if P is dividing square also, na, so P will divide themselves also. If P is dividing P1 square, so P will divide P1 also, na. P is dividing P1 square, so P will divide P1 also. So you can add P divides P1 also, P2 also and P3 also. So if P dividing P1, P2, P1, P2, P3 are the factors of A. So it implies what? P is dividing A also. Because P is dividing these factors also, it means P is dividing A also. Are you getting this? It implies P divides A also. Hence, proof. This is the theorem. P divides A also. P is divides A also. Theorem is very easy. Let me tell you. Numerically is this. If P divides A square. If P divides A square. Then P divides A also. This is the question. Okay. Now let me tell you. Let's say there is a positive integer 6. If the factors are 2 multiply 3. Means P1 and P2. This is A, this is P1, this is P2. Okay. Now what I am saying? Let's say there is a number 2. This is dividing the square of 6. So it means this will 2 will divide the square of these numbers also. Square of this, this will be divisible by 2. Arithmetic. It means any of these numbers, it is cutting. It means it is cutting 2. If this 2 is dividing 2 square also, 2 is dividing. 2 square dividing, na? 2 is dividing 2 square. So it means 2 is dividing 2 also. If 2 is dividing 2 also, it means 2 divides 2. If 2 divides 2, so it means 2 divides 6 also. It implies 2 divides 6 also. This is the theorem. 2 divides 2, na? So 2 will divide 6 also. Why? Because 2 is the factor of 6. 2 divides 2. Why? Because 2 is the factor of 6. So 2 is dividing 6 also. Same way here also. P divides P1 square. P divides P1 square. It means P divides P1 also. If P dividing P1, so P dividing A also. Why? Because these are the factors of A. So this is the theorem. This theorem will help us to solve the numericals, the exercise 1.3. This theorem will help us. Okay? Just go through it, write it, then later on we will move to the exercise number 1.3.